Hello students, now we are going to start off the next topic, transportation. Transportation in plants and animals we will discuss. So first of all, we will focus on transportation in human beings. So human being, which things are to be transported? As in earlier section we have discussed, after the digestion of the food, the nutrients are absorbed and through the blood, it is transported to other parts of the body. Not only this, in respiratory system we have discussed, gaseous exchange takes place. So blood is also taking the gas for the exchange process. So in our body, which things are transported? The things are like food, oxygen and waste material. Which waste material? Mostly the nitrogenous waste material, which are transported by the blood. So in blood, how it is transported? We know that the composition of blood, in class 9 also we have discussed, blood consists of a fluid medium called plasma, in which the cells are suspended. Plasma transports food, carbon dioxide and nitrogenous waste in dissolved form. And oxygen is carried by the red blood cells, RBC. Not only these substances, but other substances like salts are also transported by the blood. So when the blood is transported, it is moving through the tubular structure, network of tubular structure, which we tell they are the blood vessels. So when the blood is transported, it needs a pumping organ. So what is the pumping organ? That is called the heart. So here we are going to discuss about the circulatory system in human being. Various components of circulatory system are heart, blood vessels. Then we also know about the lymph, which is running side by side with the blood, and it is also having a lymphatic system. So first of all, we are going to discuss about the heart. Before starting, we must know the learning objective. It means, while learning a chapter, what are the learning outcome? So after going through the chapter, you will learn about the structure and function of the heart. You can define the process of double circulation. You will able to draw and label the diagram of the heart. You will able to explain the mechanism of circulation of blood. Then you will distinguish between arteries and veins, the lymph and blood. And also you will know about the different type of circulation in different organism. Not only this, about clotting of the blood and working of the lymphatic system. So first of all, let's start up with the heart. So whenever we are discussing about the heart, the learning objectives are, after the end of the topic, we will able to define the function of the heart, identify the different layers of the heart and their functions, identify the chambers of the heart, understand the function of the valves of the heart, understand blood flow and the cardiac cycle, understand the conducting system of the heart. So these are the learning outcomes. Then let's move on towards the structure of the heart, its shape, size and location. So if you will see, the heart is, it's a completely muscular organ and it is conical hollow structure which is located behind the sternum in the thoracic cavity. So here, thoracic cavity, the word thoracic cavity, thoracic and then the sternum. Sternum, first let's understand this word. Sternum, it is present in the front side of the rib cage, where all the ribs are attached in the front side, in the chest side. So that bone is also called the breastbone, or that is called the sternum. Then what is thoracic cavity? Our body, it is divided into different cavities. So the upper body part, that is having the thoracic cavity, and lower, that is having the abdominal cavity. Like in the thoracic cavity, heart, lungs, all the things are situated, but in the abdominal cavity, our digestive system, reproductive system, all the things are situated. Then if we will see the size of the heart, that is like of our closed fist. Then if we will see the structure of the heart is protected by a double layered membrane. It is called the pericardium, because all the delicate organs are protected by some extra cover. Heart is also covered by the pericardium. In between the pericardial membrane, what is present? The pericardial space is present, means here having a thin membranous layer. Inner to the thin membranous layer, then the heart is present. So here a space is there in between the membrane and the heart, and the space is filled with the pericardial fluid. So we must know why this pericardial fluid is there. What is the function of the pericardial fluid? The pericardial fluid, it is helpful for lubrication, for friction, like whenever the heart is pumping, and also it is helpful as a protector of from the mechanical injury. Whenever we are getting any jerk in our chest, that liquid is protecting our heart. Then we will see that in human being, heart is divided into various chambers. First it is right and left chamber, and that is divided by the septum. That muscular septum is there. Then we will see that it is altogether having four chambers, upper two chambers called the auricles, and lower two chambers called the ventricles. The auricles are the upper chambers and the ventricles are the lower chamber. The auricles are thin walled and are separated by interauricular septum. Just you see the diagram, that upper auricle and lower ventricle, they are separated by septum. Septum are just the wall like, they are for separation. Okay, they are wall like, they are separating the upper chamber from the lower chamber, and this septum is called the interventricular septum. Interauricular septum. In between the auricle, the septum is there, that is called the interauricular septum. And when in between the ventricle, that is called the interventricular septum. So if you are not remembering this, no issue. Only you must remember that four chambers of the hearts are separated from each other by means of septum. The right auricle receives impure blood from different body parts through two large veins called the superior vena cava and the inferior vena cava. So superior vena cava, why the name is given superior vena cava? Because it is collecting the blood from all over the body, means upper body part, from the head, brain, all the regions. That's why it is superior vena cava. And inferior vena cava, it is collecting the blood, deoxygenated blood, from the lower body part, and it is giving into the which part? That is the right auricle. The left auricle receives pure blood from the lungs by pulmonary vein. So here one thing we must note down, that always we are telling veins are, they are receiving the impure blood, but pulmonary vein, it is receiving the pure or oxygenated blood. From the right ventricle arises an artery known as the pulmonary artery. So this pulmonary artery, it carries the deoxygenated blood to the lungs for purification. Students always must follow the diagram. You can see the diagram given in the NCERT book also. So, or analyze the diagram, what is given in this picture. So what we got, that from the right ventricle, one artery is arising, its name is pulmonary artery, and which is carrying deoxygenated blood. Again, you just emphasize on that word, that artery carries pure blood or oxygenated blood. But here what we are discussing, it is carrying impure blood. It is one exception that it is carrying impure blood from the heart towards the lungs. From the left ventricle arises a main blood vessel known as the aorta, which carries pure blood to various body parts? So here you are getting very important 1 mark question. That is, name the largest artery of the body. The largest artery of the body, that is the aorta, which is arising from which part? That is arising from the left ventricle. And what is its function? Its function is to carry blood to all body part. The opening of the pulmonary artery and aorta are guarded by semilunar valves. Semilunar valves prevent the backward flow of blood from the pulmonary aorta and artery to their respective ventricle. Then the right auricular ventricle valve is known as tricuspid valve, and the left auricular valve is known as the bicuspid valve. So let's understand it very properly. We know that the upper chamber and lower chamber, the auricle and ventricle of respective sides, means right auricle is in connection with the right ventricle and left auricle is connected with the left auricle. So how these auricles and ventricles are connected with each other? By means of the valves. So just come to the right side. In right side, the right auricle is connected with the right ventricle by means of a valve. Its name is tricuspid valve. And the left auricle is connected with the left ventricle by means of a valve. Its name is bicuspid valve. So what do you mean by this cuspid? Why it is called the cuspid valve? Because here it is having cusps, means slabs. Three parts are there, as you can see in the diagram. Here three flaps are there. That's why it is a tricuspid valve, which is present in the right side, in between the auricle and the ventricle, or atria of the ventricle. And just opposite, bicuspid or mitral valve is there, in between the left auricle and left ventricle. So it is about the structure of the